Hi there. The shuttle bus to DNA Airlines flight number 2 to Margalis is now boarding.
Can I get you a Snapple or something, ma'am?
No, thank you.
Welcome aboard.
Is this a flight to Martells?
Yes, ma'am.
I wasn't sure. I didn't know a plane could take off from a bowling alley.
Bowling alley's out of business. We're just renting the parking lot.
Honey. Excuse me, is this your...
Yes. Sorry.
Lots of empty seats, huh?
Yes, there are.
Hi, I'm Olivia. Actually, Olive's my real name, but I've changed it. Who would name their child Olive? I mean, I would never name my child Olive. Don't get me wrong, I love olives, and I absolutely love the way they taste. Oh, especially those green ones stuffed with garlic. But to name a child Olive, it just doesn't make any sense. Did you know an olive is actually a fruit?
No.
Hope everybody is comfortable. Barney, your captain for this flight. We hope you enjoyed your stay in sunny Lina Lindu. Weather permitting, you should be cruising at about 225 mph at an altitude of about 12,000 feet.
Give it a take.
And should be arriving in Margalis in about an hour. What's up? Don't hold me to it. Just kidding. Margalis is where you will be catching your connecting flight to good old US of 8. Now, if you have any questions, or if you want a snap, Audrey here will be only too happy to assist you. Isn't that right, babe? All right. I got me clean fly.
Welcome to B&A Tropical Airlines Flat 2. I'm Audrey, and I'll be your flight attendant for today's flight.
Okay.
Well, we're going to take off, so why don't you put on your seatbelts?
Buckle mine up.
There you go. Oh, and no cell phones or computers, because it fucks with the, messes with plane sophisticated controls. Now, okay. Sure as hell use one of those. But as a professional, it's probably best I don't. Hi there.
Excuse me, what did you say your name was?
I didn't. It's Charlene.
Charlene. Charlene. Nice. Kind of rolls off the tongue. Charlene. Have you ever thought of changing it to Charlenia?
Not for a moment.
Did you fly this airline coming in?
No.
Neither did I. This was the only flight available. My sister's gonna have a baby. She's 2 weeks ahead of schedule, and I have to get home for the birth. I just know it's going to be a girl. I'm so excited! I'm gonna be an aunt! Woohoo! Aunt Olive! I mean Olivia. How to be a good aunt. Have you read it?
No.
I'm already on chapter 4. A good aunt is concerned, but not too concerned. Charlene, didn't I see you at the papaya parade?
No.
You weren't at the papaya parade?
No, I was not at the papaya parade.
Oh my God, Charlene, you missed an absolutely fabulous event. From what I hear, the only thing bigger on Lena Lindu is the Gooseberry Gala. I took hundreds of photos. Would you like to see?
No, thank you. I'm fine.
Well, I'll have to come back for that one. I can't imagine what else they could do with a gooseberry. Maybe I can even bring my niece. Or do you think that's too much involvement for me as an aunt?
Look, Olivia. I meant Olivia. Listen, don't take this personally, but I would really appreciate a little privacy right now.
Oh, okay. How little?
Excuse me?
Yes, you said you'd appreciate a little privacy. That pause I took wasn't enough privacy. Gotcha, I'll remember that in the future.
Future? We don't have a future, miss.
What are you doing? Charlene, can I help?
No, I'm finding another seat.
Charlene, I'm sorry. Please, I really am. Please don't leave me. I'm terrified to fly alone. Please, I'm not full of What are you looking at?
The ocean and boats, fishing boats.
Oh, sounds so picturesque. Let me see.
Yes, but...
Oh, look! That little boy, he just caught a fish. Oh, well, good for him.
I thought the captain said we'd be cruising at 12,000 feet.
He did say give or take.
This is a lot of take.
What's going on, girls?
People fishing. Oh, and look, they're waving. I love Lena Lindu.
It looks more like a warning to me.
Barney, what the hell are you doing out here?
Don't get your panties in an uproar, Audrey. I got it on autopilot.
Autopilot. We didn't got no autopilot! Everybody listen up, grab on our seats and put on our seatbelts!
Misunderstanding between me and the captain.
He does sometimes have his problems when he's in the air, but his landings are smooth as silk, guaranteed.
Oh, miss, can I please get one of those Snapples now?
We're all out. I'm so sorry. Can I get you water?
Water will do.
I forgot to pack it.
Well, what do you have?
I got a mint. You're welcome to it.
Oh. No, that's been sucked on.
No, it hasn't. It's the humidity.
You had that in your mouth.
No, I didn't.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. Hope everybody is doing okay up there. We are back up to 12,000 feet. Give or take.
Everything's just fine and dandy back here, Captain.
Excellent, dude. No harm, no foul. You got a little bit of fog sneaking up on us, but you all just lie back and relax, and I'm gonna try and find a way to nose my way through this soup.
Oh my god! I can't see a thing out there!
Maybe it's better that way.
Would you like a sip?
No. Thank you. I'm fine.
Really, Charlene, you do not want to get dehydrated.
Listen, I don't want a sip of your coconut thingy. I don't want to hold your sweaty little hands, and I don't want a mint with spittle on it. I just want some time to myself.
Oh, I can do that. I swear I can. Just give me a chance.
No, you can't. You apparently do not have the sensitivity to know when to butt out of someone's business.
Oh, perhaps I should find myself another seat.
You think?
Charlene, you are very hurtful. I'd rather die alone than be with someone who doesn't appreciate me. Well, that does it. I'm all packed.
You drop this. I think it might be yours. Making lifelong friends while on vacation.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Charlene, I just have to say, meeting you has been the absolute highlight on a vacation filled with highlights.
Okay.
But I just have to ask, what is your trip? I've tried my best to be your friend. I've opened myself up to you completely and fully and gotten nothing in response. I don't know what more I can do, because right now, our friendship is on life support.
Olivia, have you ever even considered the fact that I may have my reasons for wanting some solitude? That this isn't about you? Maybe I'm going through something very personal.
Well, no. What are you going through, Charlene?
It doesn't matter.
Oh, but it does matter, Charlene, it does. Please, tell me.
This has gone far enough. I'm calling the flight attendant.
Excuse me, miss. Can I get some help over here?
Oh, you bet.
But I already finished off that mint, so...
Never mind. Very well. Yesterday, after arriving in Lina Lindu, I was in my hotel room unpacking, getting ready to go out and have a great time at the papaya parade, when I received a phone call that a friend of mine had been killed in a freak accident.
Oh no, that's terrible. Oh my God, I'm so sorry, Charlene.
Thank you. So anyway, now you know why I feel the need to be with my thoughts.
Of course. Would you like to talk about it?
Did you hear what I just said?
I'm sorry. What kind of freak accident?
Are you 5 years old? If I told you, you'd only laugh.
Oh, I promise I won't. I swear, I'm only curious. Was it killer bees? Did the piano fall on him? Did he swallow
yoga? Oh, for God's sakes, it was a lava lamp.
A what?
A lava lamp.
But how?
Apparently, and according to the police, he had put the lava lamp on the stove. Probably thinking he was gonna get it to, I don't know, bubble up some more or something. And he was standing next to it watching the, you know, the bubbles. But it exploded. A shard of glass went into his heart, killing him instantly.
That is so, so sad, Charlene. But oddly funny in a weird, quirky sort of way, don't you think?
No! I don't! That's exactly why I should have never... I'm finding another scene. What the heck? It's okay. We're still alive. We're still alive. Well, would you look at that?
I have not felt turbulence like that since the monsoons of 98.
Look, I don't know what's going on. This airline? But we are terrified here.
Yes! Where are we landing?
Landing? Sweetheart, we have already landed.
Good.
Told you. The man here landed Wayne, among other things.
Welcome to Margellis, everyone.
Oh, you got about 9 minutes to make your connecting flight.
9 minutes?
Give or take.
Oh. Charlene, wait. Can I come with you to the funeral?
Absolutely not.
Can we sit together on the flight home?
I'm afraid that's not possible.
I'm flying first class.
Me too!
Great flight.
Well, thank you. Thanks for flying AMB Tropical Airlines.
That's B&A Tropical Airlines, babe.
Whatever. Sample?
Painting Uncle Henry. Painting Uncle Henry. Or perhaps your name is Uncle Bob. I don't know. Please pick up the wife. Courtesy telephone. Your nephew Clarence is waiting. I'm waiting. Hey, Clarence, that's my purse. Come back with that. Clarence. Paging Airport Security. Airport Security, please pick up the white courtesy telephone. Uncle Henry? Uncle Bob? Clarence?
London Heathrow Airport. Please do not leave your luggage unattended at any time or ask someone you don't know to take charge of it. Do not, under any circumstances, take responsibility for luggage belonging to someone you don't know.
Plain mask, London cabbies. Ah, shit! Son of a bitch. Fucking glass of Stoli.
Hey, well, at least the glass is still half full, huh?
Great. Goddamned optimist. Bet you can't see. Oh, sorry, bud. I didn't see.
That's quite all right, sir. You know, I didn't see either. You know, can I help him?
No. Yeah, thanks. I'm sorry about that. It's just, this crap happens to me all the time. It's not half full now. Say, can I buy you one? I'm wrong.
No thanks, Rob. One pair of these is enough. I'm Mike.
Well, Mike, can I buy you a real drink then?
Well, again, no thanks. I stopped drinking about 10 years ago.
Oh, what are you, a health nut? Or did you get religion?
Neither.
At the time, I just thought I'd had enough. You know, I was a pretty heavy drinker, a chain smoker, too. And now I feel much better.
Yeah, well, I haven't had nearly enough yet. Enough of a shitty wife, though. Try to put my lazy-ass kid through college. Real estate business going to hell. Too many houses. Oh, that's right. You're a non-smoker, too. Yeah, wife threatening divorce. World tensions, economy. How does some handicapped guy like you stand it anyway? I kill myself. Hell, I guess I'm just weak.
Don't sell yourself short, Rob. You know, we all got our strengths and our weaknesses and our share of problems, too. Let's see, where are you headed tonight?
JFK, then Frisco. Can't wait to get back to Napa Valley, sunny California. I came to this dank, miserable fog pocket on business. You?
Same. New York, that is. Hey, I'm glad to meet another Yank this side of the pond.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I've been to San Francisco and Napa Valley. Not as beautiful as I recall, but Manhattan's my home. I used to drive a cab here. I just came to Mary Old England to visit a friend. Hey, well, I guess we'll be on the same flight then, huh?
Yeah. Should be departing soon. Hey, you sure I can't buy you another one, Mike?
Maybe just some water, you know, if you don't mind.
Yeah, you got it.
Hey, thanks.
I know they tell us not to do this, but would you mind watching?
Yeah, no problem. I keep an eye on this stuff.
Here you go. Each tool for you, and another stolen.
Hey, thanks, Rob.
What's that you're reading?
Oh, that's Yogananda. You know, something concise and inspiring when I'm traveling, especially by air. You ever read anything of his?
No. Is it religious?
Well, yeah, it's yoga.
Yeah, well, I never could get behind that religious crap, especially with God dealing me such a shitty hand. What a fucking load.
Hey, Bob, come on. It surely isn't as bad as all that.
Oh, yeah? Well, all right, there's the lottery.
Oh?
Low end, though. Doesn't go far nowadays. Have to pay most of it out in taxes. The rest goes to the old biatch. And then there's the mortgage, car payments, business expenses. It'll all give out someday, probably just before I do.
Hey, Rob, you know, huh?
Have you ever thought about suicide?
I don't think there's a person alive who hasn't thought about it. The lottery, huh?
Well, I've thought about doing myself in. I guess I wouldn't be here, though, if I was serious.
Rob, I don't know much, but I bet we can agree that death is the one thing in life that's guaranteed. There's really no reason to fear it. Or to desire it, either.
Well, as much as that resonates, you're still a damned optimist. Glass half full. Bullshit. When are you gonna get real?
Me? Real? Oh, yeah? Well, how's this for real, Mr. Lottery? A year after I quit drinking and smoking, I found out I had type 1 diabetes. And I just retired, too. The pills, the shots, the endless blood tests, diabetic restrictions? And for what? First I lost my eyesight, then I cut off my foot. Doctors didn't think I lived through this long. But then I lost my wife. Breast cancer.
Wow.
Oh yeah, wow.
What'd you do?
I pitied myself. Despite the fact the doctor said I was dying, I wished I was dead. And I thought a lot about how to do it, too.
What changed?
I did. Faced with death, I realized I had a lot to live for. Specialist, it was so negative. I took the holistic route. Decided to do some serious emotional clearing, you know. Now, well, I accept God's will and try to create my own.
Yeah.
You know, I realized if I got rid of all that stress and anger, I just might prolong my life. Anyway, I'm feeling a lot better now. It's kind of like, you know, finding the Grail, you know? I don't have much, but I'm just grateful for each moment I'm alive.
Well, be that as it may, my life still sucks.
Come on, Rob. I've been there. I used to think it was God's dog for him to kick around, you know? I gotta lose my health before I found happiness. Turned out to be a gift, though. After all, who knows how much time he's got left?
Attention, travelers. Pan Am Flight 103 to New York City is now boarding passengers at gate 9. Please have your boarding passes ready and remember to take your carry-on luggage with you. At this point, we'd like to wish you all a lovely holiday season and a happy and prosperous year in 1989.
Well, Governor, that's us. Shall we be off?
Oh, righto, old chap. Must have dilly-dally down there, eh? What?
You flying first class, Mike?
Oh, nah. But I got a nice window seat. You know, I should get a good view of London if the fog is clear.
Well, Mike, it's been interesting. Maybe I'll see you on the other side.
Yeah, sure. He won't be long now. Rob, you take care.
We interrupt our regular program for this special news bulletin. Pan Am Flight 103, en route from London to New York, exploded in the sky above Lockerbie, Scotland this evening at approximately 7 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time, about 1/2 hour after takeoff. All passengers, most of them U.S. citizens, as well as the entire crew, are reported dead. It's also reported that several people on the ground in Lockerbie were killed by falling debris. The death toll is now estimated at over 270. We'll have more details later on as they come into our newsroom.
Airport alert. Airport alert. Looking for clearance. A little boy of 7 carrying a toy dinosaur in my very expensive Gucci purse. Airport security. Uncle Henry or Bob. Clarence? Oh, hell, I don't know who I'm paging anymore. Somebody just please, please pick up the white courtesy telephone.
Keep it moving. Keep it moving. Shoes off. All valuables and jackets in the trays. No liquids or gels over 3 ounces, please. Next.
You're my sweet thing, don't you fear. But I might just have to throw you in a river, dear. When my best friend told me that she didn't want to have children,
My heart broke for her. What kind of life would she have without the love of a child? Those sparkling eyes. Those full, wide-open mouth smiles. Where their face is so lit up, your heart just melts into a puddle. And sitting in the own love muck of your own sticky goo heart, you think that it's impossible to be any happier. Nothing can compare. No husband. No fabulous career. No designer drug. Nothing can compare to that love feeling. I tried to talk her out of it, but she'd say things like, "No, no, it looks like too much trouble. I can tell you haven't had a good night's sleep in years." And she's right, but what is sleep anyway? It's like I've found a way to eat the world's best chocolate cake for dessert every night. And she won't have any because she sees my dentist bills are going up. She's outdoorsy. So I tell her it's like I'm climbing some fantastic peak. Breathing the fresh mountain air. Feeling the fresh mountain breeze. Seeing for miles around. And she won't come with me because she sees there's some blisters on my feet. I think I'm clever for my analogies, but they fall on deaf ears. Because when push comes to shove, she just isn't in the mood to be a mother. And frankly, today, neither do I. It's just that it's so constant, 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 constant. And when you're rock bottom tired and really don't want to move anymore, it's constant some more. I haven't been able to complete a thought in 2 years, let alone a project. Turns out, the only reason you see old ladies in the scrapbook section at Michael's is because they didn't even have the time to paste a photo when the 20 years a kid was in the house. Go to any mom's group, and the list of creative projects those women come up with, but run out of time to complete, will boggle your mind. If you're not bouncing a baby, you're cooking, cleaning, doing the laundry. Learning phonics so you could teach diphthongs to your preschooler. Trying to exercise so you might someday fit back into that bikini. Or if you've got all that under control and have 5 extra minutes to spare, taking a shower. We need a real solution. Luckily, for all of you, my brain hasn't completely melted with motherhood. I have a solution I think we can all agree is our best hope. We need more wives.
Yeah, for sure.
Sure, you can laugh. I myself could use 2 or 3. And I'm sure you could too. Unless you're rich enough to afford a whole staff of housekeepers, gardeners, babysitters, and cooks. More wives are really the most economical bet to solve the time crunch crises. One wife could be in charge of dinner, while another does the laundry. Wife number 3 could take the kids out for a walk, while wife number 4 could clean the bathrooms. Some of us could even get part-time jobs and still know their kids were being raised at home by their mother. Thinking about how useful it would be to have a few extra wives around my house, I'm convinced that the moms of Western society were busy potty training when some jerk
decided to outlaw the harem. Now, of course, you'd all want some special private time with your hubby, but, and let's be frank here, okay? Who's gonna complain when most of his needs are satisfied by sexy wifey number five? Who doesn't have a baby to nurse all night yet? Once I realized the genius of my plan, I quickly went online to find a wife. That is what people do these days, right? As it happens, there's a section on Craigslist called W4WWW. So, I posted. Let me get this out for you. In quotes, wanted, wife number two, must love cooking, cleaning, and other people's babies. Must be cute enough to attract my husband, but not too much cuter than me. If you happen to be cuter than me, we might be able to negotiate a bad haircut. We're an active, fun family that you'll feel privileged to join. Extra points if you enjoy hanging out in ski lodges with kids who are not allowed to eat hot dogs. Please reply with an essay on how to remove stains from white onesies without toxic bleach. End quotes. Unfortunately, the Craigslist community flagged me before I got any responses. I was about to tell this brilliant idea of mine to my own husband, but I knew he'd say something like, having to do with one wife is more than enough. So I showed him. I handed him the laundry basket. But I haven't given up on the idea for all you other mothers out there. I hereby proclaim a new political movement. Mothers for bigamy! I think that together, we can make those toddler years a little easier. Meanwhile, as for me, I'm gonna try to convince my childless best friend to move in!
Next!
Came out here. My parents were fighting. My dad hit my mom.
I wish I could have been there for you.
I ran up here not knowing if he was going to kill her. He was drunk, and we'd gone to one of the neighbors for a barbecue. He thought some guy was coming on to my mom. That's what earned him the right to beat her up.
God, sometimes people are so stupid. Why is it that their egos are so far out of whack when they drink?
I found it under his bed last night. He would have wanted me to take it. Make a man out of you. Put hair on your chest.
No thanks. On all three counts.
Mom kicked him out that night. He went back to Sacramento, where we lived then. And Mom and I stayed here. I remember I started third grade. Made several friends. And my father came back. Had quit drinking. He said he was a changed man.
That must have been when he changed from bad to worse. Sorry.
Yeah. We moved back to Sacramento. For a while, things weren't great. Then he started drinking again. At first, not too much. Then it got bad. He'd grab me, throw me against the wall, tell me I'd never be a man. You won't amount to anything, you sorry piece of shit. I never knew what I did to cause him to do that to me.
It had nothing to do with you, Danny. Sometimes people get so twisted up in the head, they think if they destroy someone else, it'll make them look better. It only makes them look pathetic and small. For some reason, they never seem to get that.
I tried not to look at him, which made him mad. I tried to stand up to him, like I thought a man should, and that made him mad. I gave up, and that made him mad. Next morning, he'd be hungover, wondering why we weren't talking to him. He'd grab my mom, force her to the bedroom, hear him slap her around and call her names.
All us kids, the summer pack we used to call ourselves. We knew your father was abusive. My father told me to stay away from you and your family. But kids are funny, though. I didn't listen. You always seemed to find your way back into the group. You were a loner, though. I remember that.
Why the hell is it that when somebody dies, all people remember is what a great so-and-so he was? I hated that asshole. Now I won't even get the chance to... He went and pulled this shit on us.
Danny, what happened anyway? Did you have a fight or what? I'm sorry I asked.
He left a note. It said, I'll see you in hell. Why would he think to do that? He'd already made living here hell for mom and me. And he went and pulled that in the bedroom?
Danny, should we get out of here? This isn't safe.
Life isn't safe. I do this all the time. Just lie down and relax. This is the best rush I've ever had.
Danny, no! This is crazy! You've been tripping! Come on, let's go!
Dang it! Just keep your eyes open. Trust me.
Done this before.
Whatever happened to Carlos Ramirez? You remember when we stole his dad's speedboat and took it around the cove?
Yeah.
My dad would have killed me. Carlos's dad said we had to clean up his yacht and next time ask. He was so cool. You could tell he was really proud of Carlos for showing off in front of the girls.
Yeah, a little too proud if you ask me. If my kid did that, I'd ground him for months.
I always wish my father and I had that kind of close relationship. It's too late now.
You remember that day that Carlos was coming on to me and wasn't taking no for an answer?
Yeah.
You pushed him off for me.
That was my only fight. Bloody nose and all. Ben, he was really tough.
That was the day I fell in love with you. You remember? You were my knight in shining armor.
Megan, I was a squeaky-voiced, pimply-faced, 13-year-old boy.
With a bloody nose for defending my honor.
Yeah. I had a huge crush on you. I always thought you liked Carlos, though.
No! I didn't like his dad, either. Two peas in a pod those two were. Not at all my type. I go for the quiet, sweet, sensitive voice.
I always wonder who the travelers are as they pass overhead. Happy to be home or running away from bad memories?
I think that when I look at houses. I wonder what that house is like on the inside. Are the people happy or angry or just too busy?
Your house was always more than fun. I really like being there.
Yeah. I really am lucky. I look around at some of the other kids I go to school with and think how awful my life would be if I had to live in their world.
I hate God. I hate the church. I hate my father. I hate God!
Why do you hate God?
Mom took us to church in Sacramento. She tried to get help leaving my father. But they said they don't help families break apart. Only help them stay together. And that my father was the head of the household. He sure as hell was the head of our household. He used to say, this was his Lord and Savior. Get genie in a bottle.
Danny, if we ever had kids, what would you do differently? Would you be like your father?
Hell no! I'd never be like that bastard. I want my kids to love and respect me.
Well, we better get going. Your mom's gonna be super worried about you.
My kids will never see me drunk. You hear that, you son of a bitch? I won't be like you. I won't win this battle. You can't beat me. I won't let you.
Will somebody out there please pick up the white courtesy telephone? Is there anybody in this entire airport listening to me? No?
No.
Well, then I quit. Clarence can find his own damn uncle.
May I have your attention, please? The flight from Doodakhatania is on time, and we are proud to say that that country has chosen the Arcata Airport in which to land its first import to the USA of Doodakhatanian gork meat and clopper. It will take a few extra moments to hose down the plane's interior, so expect a slight delay in takeoff.
Dada, da mama, blurk. Dada, da mama, blurk. Hello. Dada, da mama, blurk. English. Ha, Doodakhatania, here we come! Booty! Oop da! Do not ba lorgu! Okay, I got this. Oop da! Do da blah! Oh, blah, blah, blah! Oh, I might have figured you'd study, Patty. Help me with this shit, will you? What did they let you bring all this as carry on? Well, I have my ways. Even so, I had to stuff my coconut bra in one suitcase and my snorkel in another. They wouldn't let me wear it around my neck.
You brought two suitcases?
Well, hell yeah, we're gonna be gone a whole week.
That list that I emailed you a month ago was so you would bring just the essentials.
Well, you left out some pretty important stuff.
Right. And did you look at the itinerary I sent you?
Well, kind of.
No. We are going to a strange and foreign country. Now, we will have a better and a safer time if we know what we're doing in advance. Da?
No way.
Now, you mean bleak da.
Okay, bleak da.
I made reservations.
No way. I mean bleak da. I am not going to let your inner control freak plan this trip. I want an adventure. And you need an adventure. We are going to go with the Doodakhatanian flow. None of that run-of-the-mill tourist shit for us. And we are definitely not going on one of those phony guided tours.
Tours can show you things that you might otherwise miss. Now, do you remember?
Come on, Pen. This time, we are going to do it my way. I know you. You've never done a trip that's like free. We are going to go to Doodakhatania, and we are going to mingle with the natives. Ride a gorg.
Maybe the slaughterhounds.
Or we're going to drink some Murgle and help them harvest their fields of clobber. Climb Mount Doodah. Oh, swim with the Nagasaur. And do that dance.
What's the name of that dance they do in the Moon's Full?
Oh, wait a minute. Let me find it.
Oh, do you mean the midnight one or the 3 a.m. one?
Oh, the 3 a.m. one.
It's called the Schlumbaschler Do It, which means the erotic pufferfish dance. And there is no way I am doing that. That is the one where they attach a mummified pufferfish to each elbow.
I read about it. It means you're eligible.
Yeah, well, I don't want to be eligible. And besides which, I am a married woman.
Well, I'm not. By the way, how is Howard with this? He's okay? You going on this trip? Huh?
He doesn't know. He's at one of his Buddhist retreats. Total silence for 2 weeks.
Oh my God, I think I'd die. Well, he's certainly gonna find out when you come home with two mummified pufferfish hanging off both elbows.
I am not having pufferfish attached to my body. Believe it, God. And by the way, I am not gonna swim with any nagasaurs either. I do not like slimy animals with no eyes.
So you can let me have all the fun? That? Is that slight on time?
No, last time I looked.
Zambia, Anchorage, Tierra del Fuego. Oh God, I can't believe it. After all this time, they still don't have a fucking flight to Los Angeles. Where's our flight?
It's right there.
Oh, Arcata to Doodakhatania. On time. 12:37. Hooray! Oh, I got this. Shaputa.
That's right, Booty. Shaputa. You have been studying.
Oh, don't be too impressed. It's the only word I know besides da and bleep da, of course.
Well, you know, you really should learn da-da, ga-mama, blurk English. Look.
Oh, hell, Patty, I'll never get that. You're the smart one.
True.
Well, at least you have gained weight. I know, isn't it great? I set a goal for 15 pounds, and I did it. I ate like a pig to get ready for this trip. Or should I say, like a gourd? See? Shabuta! Shabuta indeed. They are gonna love you in Doodakhatania. Me, all I gained was a little extra love handle.
Oh, let me see.
Well, you know what that means. The natives are going to lock you up in whatever those underground cellars are called and stuff you with bark lard and fatten you up.
You think so?
I brought this big old thick jacket so that I would look fat.
That's not going to fool anybody.
Well, stop it. I read in my book that they have outlawed that custom for years, and that if you stay in the well-traveled areas and travel in groups, like tours, then you do not run the risk of being fat.
Can you believe that?
Booty! You are just trying to scare me like you did when we were kids.
I know. I'm sorry.
No more?
No more.
You promise?
Promise.
Okay. Let's go over the checklist.
If we must.
Okay. Gork whistle. Check. Whopper chopper. Check. Volcanic ash aspirator.
Wow, wouldn't it be cool if Bob Judah just spewed while we were there?
Did you bring one?
Check.
Toad net.
Linda, forgot, I'll borrow yours.
Laxatives?
Check.
How many?
Two.
Only two. Pooty, you know what the book says. The Doodakhatanian diet is extremely constipatory.
I know. But I plan on drinking lots of Murgle. You know what the book says. Gork meat and clopper is a stopper, but Murgle makes you gurgle.
It also makes you drunk. Now, Pootie, you promised me
I know. I'll be good. Sort of. Oh, hell, Patty. We are going to who knows where and who knows what. Chabuta!
Yeah. Chabuta! Now let's finish the checklist.
Oh my God, I think I forgot to pack my condoms. I put them right on top of my Kama Sutra book last night, so I don't forget.
Oh, Lord. Great! Now let's get back to the checklist.
Murgle bug.
Check.
Okay.
Nagasaur repellent.
Oh, no repel for me? Thank you very much. I plan on swimming with them. Eyes or no eyes. I hear it's very sensual when they let them squirm all over your body.
You two lovely ladies must be off to Doodakit.
Uh-huh. I'm a doll. You?
Sure am. Doll.
Our flight's on time.
Well, that's nice.
Is that all your luggage?
Yes. I'm in Humboldt County briefly. For a meeting. Business. I live in Doodakit.
Really? Well, come sit with us.
I'm Prudy. This is Patty.
I'm Richard.
So you live in Doodakhatania?
About 4 years now.
Well, that's interesting, because I read that foreigners aren't allowed to live there.
unless they marry a Doodakhatanian.
You did that?
I sure did.
But my book says that Doodakhatanian girls get married when they're only 3 years old.
Well, and that's right. My wife just turned 6. As a matter of fact, I've got a photograph of her right here. Would you like to see it?
Yeah.
Lovely, isn't she? When she turns 12, we'll be able to touch each other, holding hands only. And we'll live together and, you know, perform, pardon my language, shroom shrimpish when she turns 16.
Well, you'll probably be dead by then.
That may be, but in the meantime, I've got it made. I married into the prestigious tribe of the Falling White Toad, which gives me incredible inns, a great place to live, if you don't mind the smell of gorkai, at the base of Mount Duda. I can also travel back and forth to the States whenever I like with my special white toad passport. And I have a number of business prospects that I'm trying to expand at Doodakhatane. Oh, well, here, I have a couple of cards for you.
Dick's Doodakhatanian Tours.
That's me.
Gork rides, clopper harvesting, climb Mount Duda, dance the Sherlock blah, 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 pufferfish optional, Merkle Festival, ooh, swimming with the Nagasaurs, fattenings. I bet they're big fattenings, right?
Well, I must admit that the natives do stage a reenactment, but if you want a real fattening, we can do that. We can do everything that's to be done and do not contain it.
I guess. Well, how much?
Pardon me?
How much?
Well, that depends on what you want to do, but, since we're all such good friends, I'm sure a special price can be had.
Oh my God, we haven't gone on the flight yet. We're on our way.
I can also set you up with a great place to live, to stay. Here, I've got I own a little place myself called the Doodah Palace. Here are cards for both. That's why I'm in Humboldt County, to expand my prospects and, take a very special meeting with some very big names in the hotel motel biz. Lone Pine. It's the Matrona Motel. The Brass Ring. See if any of the locals want to get in on the ground floor and set up shop at Doodakhatane. I, of course, would be the person with the connection to the tribe of the Falling White Toad to facilitate it all. I'll tell you, Doodakhatane is ripe for the picking.
So, King Dick of the White Toad sells out his adopted country.
Yep, it's a good life. I've got plenty of jingle in my pockets with lots more to come. And although I may not be considered a very hot catch here in the States, in Doodakhatania, I am, shall we say, very much admired.
Oh, lots of shloom shlurping?
Exactly.
In spite of being married.
It is expected.
Well, I for one don't think you're so bad state. Sigh. Do you think Patty and I can have separate rooms at the Doodah Palace?
I will have two of my finest gork suites waiting, hosed down and clean. Here, make a phone call.
May I have your attention, please? Flight 000 Doodakhatania is now welcoming passengers in White Toad class at Gate 1. Attention flight 000 to Doodakhatania welcomes passengers in white tote class only to board at gate number 1.
Well, that's me. So nice to meet you, Miss Patty. Miss Pootie, I will see you at the Doodah Palace, and I will give you a tour that you will never forget. Keep those elbows ready. Da da.
Ta ta. Pootie, you're going to go all the way to Doodakhatania with me, and then you're going to spend all your time with that mirror. Atlas, entrepreneur, toad.
Not all my time.
I know you.
Well, I bet when we get there, there'll be free Myrtle in our room.
Me, Doc.
And if I play my cards right, I bet I can arrange for some free tours.
Pootie, Balik-da, da, Balik-da, da,
Balik-da, da.
Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me. Let's float down to Peru. In Lava Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's float down in the blue. And once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just fly. Sorry, once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You will hear angels cheer because we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. You just say the words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, that you will hear the angels cheer because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a gasping day. You just say those words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Back up, let's fly, wait.